Hey, welcome to edX World, another video in the IGCSE Economics series. In the previous two videos, we've studied about demand, supply, the individual demand, the market demand, and same way individual supply, market supply. In each of the lessons, we studied the demand curves, we studied the changes in demand, we studied movements along the demand curve and movements along the supply curve. So in today's video, we will combine the two concepts of demand and supply and understand the equilibrium in market. When is it established? When is the equilibrium established in the market? What do you mean by equilibrium? What happens when there is no equilibrium? And what happens if there is equilibrium in the market, but market conditions change? All of these will be covered today. So let's begin this lesson by understanding what do you mean by equilibrium, market equilibrium. Market equilibrium is that level of price where the quantity demanded by the market is equal to the quantity supplied by the market, and as a result there is balance in the market. Equilibrium means balance, and balance happens when the quantity demanded equals to the quantity supplied. You know that the demand curve is a downward sloping curve and the supply curve is a upward sloping curve. So for both of them to be equal, they have to intersect at a point. So the point where the two curves intersect is known as the market equilibrium point. In the previous two videos, we studied demand schedule and supply schedule. We plotted the points on the graph. Let's combine these two data from the previous two videos and let's see how can we derive equilibrium in the market. If you see the first level of price, $1,500, quantity demanded, gadgets demanded were 1,500 units, whereas gadgets supplied were 12,000 units. See, gadgets supplied are higher than the gadgets demanded, and as a result, there will be disequilibrium in the market. Equilibrium will happen in the market when the customers and the producers are in balance. They do not change their quantity demanded and quantity supplied in the market. Again, at 1,250 price, if you see quantity supplied, which is gadgets supplied, is still higher than gadgets demanded. Same for $1,000 price level. But when I go to $750 of price level here, the price is cheap, so consumers are demanding high, but it is not as much profitable for many of the suppliers in the market. So many of the suppliers do not want to supply, and as a result, the total gadgets supplied in the market reduce. So we can say that our market equilibrium point lies somewhere between a price level of $1,000 and $750, wherever the gadgets demanded will be equal to the gadgets supplied. Let's plot these two schedules, the demand schedule and the demand supply schedule, on the graph again, and let's see if we can arrive at the market equilibrium point. So we have price on the y-axis and quantity of gadgets demanded and supplied on the x-axis. So plotting the demand curve, we have a downward sloping demand curve. Plotting the supply curve, we have an upward sloping supply curve. And if you see the two graphs, which is the demand curve and the supply curve, intersect at a point, and at this point the price is $900 and the quantity demanded and supplied is 3,800 units. It means whenever the price in the market is $900, the producers will produce and supply 3,800 units. Consumers will demand 3,800 units. There will be balance in the economy, there will be balance in the market, and as a result, market will stay in equilibrium. There will be no further movement in the market. So next we have to study what do you mean by disequilibrium. See, disequilibrium in market will be there when the current market price is either higher than the equilibrium price or lower than the equilibrium price. So the first situation we have is that the current market price is higher than the equilibrium price at $1,250. So let's plot this price level on the graph. At this price, 1,250, the consumers find the product quite expensive, and hence they are not demanding as many units as they were demanding at a price level of 900 level. But the suppliers find this price quite profitable, because higher the price, higher their profits, and hence they're willing to supply a lot of quantity to the market. They are willing to supply 8,000 units of this product to the market. When the suppliers supply 8,000 units, but the consumers are demanding only 2,000 units, as a result, there will be a surplus of 6,000 units in the market. See, as a producer, when customers do not walk in and do not buy the product, we have a lot of extra inventory left, As producers, what would be the natural reaction? The natural reaction would be to reduce the prices so that we can just get rid of the extra inventory. No producer wants to hold on to extra stock because there is storage cost involved. Products might be perishable. They might not be in a saleable condition after a few weeks, after a few months. Hence, producers start giving discounts, start reducing the prices, and they keep on doing this until the prices come back to $900 level and the quantity demanded is equal to the quantity supplied. So this is the automatic force of the market, which pushes the prices from 1250 to 900 levels. This is known as the market force. Let us also take an example wherein the price is lower than the equilibrium price and the current market price is going at $250 level. If you plot this price on the graph, we see that this price is quite cheap for the consumers and hence they're willing to buy, or hence they're demanding 10,000 units of gadgets at this price. But when we see from suppliers' point of view, as the price goes down, their profits go down. Hence, many suppliers may not be willing to supply at this price. So the market supply just stands at 1,000 units. When demand is 10,000, market supply is 1,000, obviously there will be a shortage of 9,000 units in the market. The natural reaction of producers to this would be to increase the price when they see that there is shortage in the market, when they see that there is deficit in the market. They would want to try and sell to people who are willing to pay the highest prices. As a result, the market forces will push the prices up from $250 level to $900 level until the quantity demanded is equal to quantity supplied. So whenever there is disequilibrium in the market, market forces will automatically push the prices back to the equilibrium level. Let's say currently the market is in equilibrium. Market situations can change at any time. We've seen in the demand and supply lesson that demand can change, it can increase or decrease. Same way supply can change, it can increase or decrease. Once the demand and supply changes, there will be a new equilibrium established in the market. So let's say again, continuing our example on gadgets, current market price is 900 and the quantity demanded and supplied is 3,800 units. Market is in equilibrium, but there is an increase in market demand. Reasons could be many for this increase. There could be an increase in the income of the consumer, a fall in the direct taxes. There could be an increase in the price of some substitute product to gadgets. As a result, there is an increase in market demand. After there is an increase in the demand, the current market prices are still going at $900 level. At this price, the quantity supplied is 3,800 units, but the quantity demanded is higher now. At this price, the quantity demanded is higher because of an increase in demand. And as a result, again, there would be shortage in the market. The shortage will push the prices back to the new equilibrium level, which is P1, and hence the market forces will push the price from P to P1 and increase the quantity from Q to Q1. What happens if there is a decrease in the market? Reasons again could be many: fall in income, increase in taxes, fall in the prices of substitutes, increase in the price of complements. So let's say the demand curve has shifted to the left, there is a decrease in demand. And in this new situation, at the current price levels, the quantity supplied is 3,800 units, but the quantity demanded would reduce. And as a result, there will be surplus in the market. The surplus would push the price from P to P1. It would reduce the market prices from P to P1 and decrease the market quantity from Q to Q1. Now let's see what happens if there is an increase in the market supply. Again, market supply could increase due to many reasons. The cost of production might have fallen. The government might have reduced indirect taxes. There could be increase in the individual suppliers in the market. So let's say the market supply has increased and shifted to right from S to S1. In this situation and at the current market price, the quantity demanded would still be 3,800 units, but the quantity supplied would be higher. Whenever the quantity supplied is higher than the quantity demanded, there's surplus in the market. And we've seen that the surplus will tend to push the price down from P to P1 and increase the quantity from Q to Q1. And if there is a decrease in the market supply, the supply curve will shift to the left. At the current price level, the quantity demanded is still 3,800 units, but as we can see that the quantity supplied is definitely lower than 3,800 units, there will be shortage in the market. The shortage will tend to move the price up from P to P1 and decrease the quantity from Q to Q1. So these are the various scenarios wherein the change in market conditions will cause a change in the equilibrium price and quantity. So summarizing all of that, if there is an increase in the demand, the market price and quantity both would increase. But if there's a decrease in demand, the market price and quantity both would decrease. Whereas when there is an increase in supply, the market price would decrease and quantity would increase. Whereas if there is a decrease in supply, the market price will increase and the quantity would decrease. I hope you've understood the concept of equilibrium and disequilibrium. If you've enjoyed the video, please like the video, please share the video with your friends. Next, I will be posting a video on price elasticity of demand and supply. So if you've not yet subscribed to the channel and if you've not yet pressed the bell icon, please do so. Many more videos will be coming up. Thank you for being there. I'll see you soon.